In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.
Yes.
My brothers and sisters, we begin our new calendar year of 2021. With the opportunity to honor our Blessed Mother, Mary, the Mother of God, and the gift of her Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, and the gift of God's salvation. And we give thanks to prepare ourselves for the celebration of the Eucharist. Let us pause for a moment and acknowledge our sin and ask the Lord for his mercy.
I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks.
O God, who through the fruitful virginity of Blessed Mary bestowed on the human race the grace of eternal salvation, grant, we pray, that we may experience the intercession of her, through whom we were found worthy to receive the author of life, our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Numbers. The Lord said to Moses, "Speak to Aaron and his sons and tell them, 'This is how you shall bless the Israelites.' Say to them, 'The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord let his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you kindly and give you peace.' So shall they invoke my name upon the Israelites, and I will bless them." The word of the Lord.
May God bless us in his mercy.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, when the fullness of time had come, God sent his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, to ransom those under the law, so that we might receive adoption as sons. As proof that you are sons, God sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, crying out, "Abba, Father." So you are no longer a slave, but a son. And if a son, then also an heir through God. The Word of the Lord.
Lord be with you. We're reading the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The shepherds went in haste to Bethlehem and found Mary and Joseph, the infant lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known the message that had been told to them about this child. All who heard it were amazed by what had been told them by the shepherds. And Mary kept all things, reflecting on them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, just as had been told to them. When 8 days were complete for his circumcision, he was named Jesus, the name given him by the angels, for he was conceived in the womb. The Gospel of the Lord.
In our understanding of God's revelation to us, God's revelation of His love to humanity, we can discern a particular movement of God giving and God receiving. God gives us the gift of His Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, and through our faith in Him, we are baptized and adopted, received by God into His kingdom, co-heirs to His kingdom. God gives to us, and God receives us into His kingdom. During this Christmas season, perhaps we have had the experience of giving gifts and receiving gifts. It's important to give well, but also important to receive well. Gifts are given to us, but do we receive them well? We give gifts to others, but do others receive our gifts well? Perhaps we have experienced buying and giving a toy to a child, eager with anticipation at how much the child will enjoy it, only to see that the child prefers another toy and does not really have any interest in our gift. It can be a disappointing and discouraging experience. Just as well, maybe we had the joyous experience of thinking hard on a gift, making it or purchasing it, and giving it in eager anticipation to someone. And when they receive it, they are elated and love the gift, thanking you for your thoughtfulness. How did you know? How did you know I would love this? Or, you know me so well, thank you so much. I'm going to put this gift that you got me in a very special place. Very often, their joyful and thankful reaction is gift back enough to the giver. Throughout sacred scripture, we see this particular movement between God giving gifts to humanity and humanity's reaction to such gifts. At times, humanity or a particular human does not receive the gift well. Either doesn't see its goodness or sees its goodness but prefers something else, or receives the gift but does not integrate it into his or her life. At other times in sacred scripture, we see this movement between God giving gifts to humanity and human beings reacting, responding with thankfulness and joy, receiving God's gift well. And it is in good and thankful reception of God's gifts that we're able to give God anything at all. Even our ability to give thanks is a gift from God. Our Blessed Mother, the Blessed Virgin Mary, her reception of God's gift and her joy, her thankfulness, and her cooperation with God's gift returns the gift to God through her joy, through her cooperation with God's plan of salvation. Mary is favored and able to see this goodness of God's gift, the goodness not just for her, but to all of Israel and to all of humanity for eternity. Mary shows us how to receive the gifts we receive from God. She shows us that receiving gifts from God can be an experience of a particular moment and also an experience of an entire lifetime. Mary shows us how to receive God's gifts with humility, joy, and thankfulness. And Mary also shows us how to share those gifts with others. Mary shared her Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, with the entire world. Mary has shared her Son, Jesus, with you and me. She has shared Jesus with you and me. She gave birth to God into time and space. She fed him. She clothed him. She soothed him. And she dedicated this most precious gift of a child to the Creator of all children, God the Father. Through the Holy Spirit and the cooperation, her grace, our Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of God, the second person of the Holy Trinity, was conceived and born into the world. Mary is the mother of God, not because she existed before God, but simply because she is the mother of Jesus, who is fully God and fully human, the mother of Jesus. This is what we mean when we say Mary is the mother of God. Theotokos, God bearer. She bears God to the world. We celebrate our Blessed Mother Mary today. As Christians, Mary is our mother. She is the mother of Christ, our Lord, through whom we have been adopted into the family of God. Mary is also our model for discipleship, as our model of how to follow the Christ and how to receive the gifts of God well, as our model of how to share those gifts received from God well. When we receive the gifts from God well and share them with joy with everyone, we give back to God. We dedicate those gifts to Him, to God, the source of our gift of life, the source of our thanksgiving, and the source of all that is good. The Almighty has done great things for us, and holy is His name.
Let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
Amen.
On this day, we commemorate the divine motherhood of Mary. We unite our prayers to those of Our Lady and implore the Heavenly Father to look favorably upon our petitions. Our response today is, Mary, intercede for us.
Mary, intercede for us.
That the Blessed Mother instruct and guide her children in the way of salvation, we pray. For peace on earth, the people of all nations commit themselves to establishing universal peace in truth, justice, charity, and liberty, we pray. For all of us here today, may resolve to carry the blessings we receive from the Eucharist to our families, friends, co-workers, and neighbors, we pray. That this new year be a time of peace and abiding love for all families, we pray. For all mothers, like the Blessed Virgin Mary, be able to treasure their blessings and reflect on them in their hearts, we pray. The grace to deepen our devotion to the Blessed Virgin Mary, we pray. For the faithfully departed, in particular Lourdes Espinoza, wife of Angel Espinoza, mother of Eric and Adam, and all departed loved ones, and they come to share in the fullness of life and love in heaven, we pray.
Mary, intercede for us.
Let us ask for our Blessed Mother's intercession. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Heavenly Father, we offer to you our prayers in union with those of the Virgin Mary, who bore the eternal Word of God in her chaste womb. Hear and answer them in your love and wisdom, through Christ our Lord. Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
God, who in your kindness begin all good things and bring them to fulfillment, grant to us who find joy in the solemnity of the Holy Mother of God, that just as we glory in the beginnings of your grace, so one day we may rejoice in its completion. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With
lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name on the solemnity of the motherhood of the Blessed Ever Virgin Mary. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, the angels praise your majesty. Dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the
indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Gustavo, our Archbishop, Michael, his auxiliary bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Now offer each other a sign of that peace.
Sins of the
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Behold.
compassion inhabits those who fear him. He has done great things with his arms, scattered the proud, rulers are brought down, and he has lifted the
right here in this place, oh Lord, let us
Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Let us pray. We have received this heavenly sacrament with joy, O Lord. Grant, we pray, that it may lead us to eternal life, for we rejoice to proclaim the Blessed Ever Virgin Mary, Mother of your Son and Mother of the Church. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please remain standing for a few announcements.
Just a reminder, the office will be closed tomorrow on January the 1st for the New Year's holiday. A regular adoration, that's today actually, regular adoration hours will resume on Monday, January the 4th. A reminder that St. PJ's Children's Home is in need of new twin bed sheets, standard pillows, and bath towels for the children they serve. The Catholic Daughters will be collecting these items the weekend of January 9th and 10th after all Masses. Requested colors are pink, yellow, blue, gray, and beige. We ask our parish to bless the children who are in need with our help, with our gifts, and prayers.
On behalf of Deacon David, the clergy, and the staff here at Holy Trinity, we want to wish you a very Merry Christmas and a very happy, joyful, and safe and blessed New Year. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads to receive God's blessing. May God, the source and origin of all blessing, grant you grace, pour out his blessing in abundance, and keep you safe from harm throughout the year. Amen.
Amen.
May he give you integrity in the faith, endurance in hope, and perseverance in charity with holy patience to the end.
Amen. Amen.
May he order your days and your deeds in his peace. Grant your prayers in this and in every place, and lead you happily to eternal life.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon all of you and remain with all of you forever.
Amen. This Mass is then go forth, glorifying the Lord by your life. Thanks be to God.
Our sending forth song is Let There Be Peace on Earth.
Blessed New Year.